Hello and welcome back to Star Trek New Worlds. And when we last left off, well, to be honest, I couldn't really give you a good summary of what happened because things were extremely hectic and we were under pressure the entire time. But according to the initial mission briefing, we wanted to stop the Taubert from activating an anti-Hubrian weapon of some description. And as it turns out, not only were we too late, they actually opened a portal and yeah, caught in a couple of their friends, and their combat vessels seemed to be identical to the Hubrian faction for what I can tell, but maybe there's something more to this. And well, speaking of positive things, the game seems to have become a lot more stable after the tweaks I made in DXWnd a couple of episodes ago, so hopefully this is a trend that will continue, because as a reminder, there is no save game option in Star Trek New Worlds, and the missions, they tend to last longer and longer and longer, you know, as we progress for the campaign. And I think we're up to mission number 6 now, maybe 7, and well, we can check, of course. And I think the next one is titled Knowledge is Power, which is something I can agree with. It is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so indeed this is the 6th mission in the campaign. And wow, it has been a very tough journey getting here, and it's not even, yeah, we're not even close to the finish line. And yeah, as a reminder as well, this is the easiest difficulty in this game, so... Alrighty, then we just let the Colony Affairs commander take over and tell us what job has been set out for us today.
Thirteen days ago, a survey team on Bersai 4 discovered another Metar portal ring. We suspected an invasion, so the Third Fleet was stationed in orbit while the site was investigated. Yesterday, the entire force, some 37 warships, was destroyed by the Metar.
Great.
Our fleet was severely damaged by a first Metar attack wave and annihilated by a second.
Well, what are we supposed to do then with all dinky ships, huh?
Ships surviving the first assault threw themselves in front of the Metar's weapons to buy time for the science team working aboard the flagship. They managed to stow their computer core in an escape pod and jettison it before the flagship succumbed.
So we are recovering some escape pods, yes? Probably a race against the Federation.
You are to assume command of the Bersai facility. Its resources are at your disposal. Do whatever is necessary to retrieve the pod. An upgraded science facility will be essential for processing the data, and you are tasked with improving the colony's defensive systems. Bersai 4 is now infested with Metar from the attacking ships. The flagship's final transmission reveals the pod landed in this area. The transponder was damaged during launch, so we cannot be more precise. The search will have to be conducted visually. When you find it, use a science vehicle to extract the data and relay it directly to the colony science facility. It can be transmitted from there on the secure frequency to our nearest warship. This will be no simple recon and recovery mission. First, Bersai 4 is now a Metar stronghold. Second, something that brings shame to all Klingons. The fleet had two weaklings among its ranks. Klingons who chose an ignoble escape over a glorious death. Two more escape pods were jettisoned during the battle. From life sign scans, the cowards have been identified as Chief Scientist Daga and Fleet Commander Krusk. Daga may still prove useful in analyzing the data. Rescue him if possible. As for Krusk, dragging his whimpering carcass before the High Council would complete his dishonor. But as the ranking field officer, you have the right to gut him like a target.
Seems that excessive, really. Can't really blame the guy. But then, so I think that's all we can accomplish in the mission briefing, and well, to be honest, I think the Klingon High Council and the Colonial Affairs by extension have really underestimated the Taubert, because when we started this campaign, they had a misplaced sense of superiority and were quite dismissive of their capabilities, and as it would appear, they have pretty much outwitted us, and now everyone involved, and that goes for the Romulan as well as the Federation faction, of course. Well, considering that this is a stronghold, yeah, according to the briefing, I'm not quite sure if we can manage, but that means we also have to bring our base defenses online at the earliest convenience. Well then, here's hoping that we can manage. Well, I really not quite sure what's up. We have two phaser tanks, yeah, two in total. Wow, that's lovely. Okay, what else have we online so much? We need some resources, we need a recon vessel. Okay, das ist ein Vorteil, if it has to be kept online, of course, free. Yeah, wäre dies so der Science was alright, so maybe we soon with a couple of artillery pieces, which won't last very long against the opposition, of course, and what else is around? So, mining station already. You're just lacking a resource processor apparently. Alright, so you go on squad number one and then we find something to scan, ideally, without bumping into the enemy. And at least we have multiple types of minerals available. And I don't know, these guys there will just set themselves to base defense for now, because it's all I can do with them at the moment. You have to find the enemy and alright, the APCs they can hang back some place and try to stay out of trouble. We probably will need them later. So, and you guys, set yourself to base defense. Then we also need to upgrade the quality hub at the earliest opportunity, of course. Alright, let's try to direct this, we also need to build a second mining base as soon as possible, also some generators, of course, so we are not completely defenseless, and, we can maybe tuck them in the back here someplace. Yeah, that seems to be a decent idea, actually. Is it also possible? It doesn't seem to be, so we put them here, at least a couple of those, and that should be well defended with turrets once we have the opportunity. Yeah, so, we block this off by extension. I don't think they could anything in particular with that. So let's see, silicon, so that maybe solve our resource problem from last video, that would be great. Yep, have built the construction yard, yes, where is it? Did they not? Yeah, construction yard, alright, so the collector's not online yet, that would be why. The graveyard is also required, of course, we put it, so I'm still getting familiar with the icons, so I think we need, apparently this is unsuitable. Complete. Might we put it here? Resource processor, go here, I think. So anything else we need to upgrade? I think we have to wait before we do anything else, or can do anything else for that matter. Science is crucial in this mission. I think we can put it over here on this snowy tire. So, okay, no combat vessels in the immediate vicinity, which is something. And then we zoom out a little bit and see how large this map actually is. So, quite extensive. Alright, so, interesting. Maybe we have some time to build up our defenses before we move out, that would be good. But, yeah, if we zoom out the map, it gets really sluggish. So, I think this is still the best compromise. So, what about our objectives for that matter? Because at the moment, I'm a little at a loss as to what to do. So, science block. So we have to upgrade this to the fullest, essentially, and photon turrets are pretty much given on this mission. Okay, the escape port. Right. So we have to, I don't think we can scan for this. We need ice personally, I believe. And we can also speed this up with a recon vessel or two. Alright, this seems to be suitable, and I think we should be able to set on a mine someplace. Ideally on top somewhere there. Yeah, that would be good.
Vehicle complete. Vehicle complete.
So not is they're building this apparently they are. Interesting. Okay, what else can we set down right now? We need to upgrade some facilities if we can already, that would be good. For instance, our construction yard, that would be why we have not access to anything else right now. So there's the recon vessel. At least one of those. Should be a little speedier. Maybe we can find one of these escape ports over here someplace, assuming this is possible. We'll see.
Resource structure complete.
I'd rather use them than the science vessel. Of course, it's way too slow and it cannot avoid enemy fire anyhow. So, what about that mining station of ours? That is. Well, that's a little unfortunate, isn't it? Doesn't seem to be a suitable size for us, I can tell. Not even a single one, so, alrighty then. Here we do a little scouting. We go to the other side. I think that is. Yes, yeah, seems to. No, where's our wedding point for that matter? Do we have to babysit everything? So it's where our ships start out for the most part, alright. Oh, fantastic. Okay, well, science vessel, okay, head back as soon as possible, come on. Get back to the ready point, we use the expendable recon vessels. So we have made first contact, and this guy is also refusing to move. Probably get destroyed here anyhow, right? Maybe able to scoot past, but they won't really count it, to be honest. Yeah, there we go, was a one-shot kill for them, as expected. But by me, we leave the mine alone. But we extract some minerals, because there should be at least a one-tail over here someplace, right? Well, apparently not, and we use the other mineral field if we can. So, Well, upgrade the up as well, please. And we need to upgrade our defenses. That also means the science station. We need more power. And then also replace these with the advanced one at the earliest convenience. Yeah, that would also be a good idea. And we don't have to be worried about access for maintenance or anything of that nature. So, resource collectors online. We only need one of those. We need vehicle crews, so that can go over here someplace, ideally. The side of the base, but we do not make it too crowded because, well,
construction
it interferes with vehicle pathfinding, unfortunately.
Standing by.
I think this is also dead end, so we put the arsenal all the way in the back. It should be a little safer, I hope. Both situation seems acceptable still. But is that other scouts still frozen in place? Great. Not to the V. What can we build for that matter? These things are useless in combat, especially against the all powerful beings, so we don't even worry about that.
Power generator complete.
Yeah, shield generator is the first thing we have to set down before we can put any turrets. Yeah. Get moving, guys, you have work to do. So, what is that vehicle weathering system refusing to move? Yes, I would be why. So are we completely boxed in? Is that what you're telling me? Pathfinding issues and the thing with the ability to get over there, but at least not all the vessels are of the Hubum variety, which is something at the very least. Okay, good job, folks. Was not fantastic, but I think we'll take it. At least for now. Our defenses are still a little on the weaker side, of course, so we need to reduce the load from the power grid eventually with that farm, so maybe put it down right away if we can. So what else needs upgrading? Yeah, processor for instance, and also move some stuff here, probably the engineer. Oh. Okay, we also need more tanks for base defense, but they have not become unlocked yet, unfortunately, because the vehicle yard is still the second basic variety. Yeah, so they are lovely, so we get completely wiped out by a couple of vessels. Mm-hmm, completely defenseless. Well, I don't think... Yeah, APCs are useless, it's a waste of resources. Tracker system. So, is the arsenal online already? And where did that recon vessel go? Also, apparently was destroyed already, that's great. Okay, we set out a second mine at the very least. Because one field won't do. Yeah, really won't. Apparently that's nowhere. Wow, that's great. So we have a couple more ships incoming. Fantastic. Can we build anything that's worthwhile? Yeah, pop out a couple of these, please. One artillery piece, and we need the shield generator. There it is. And I think they blew up the arsenal already. That's lovely. So we just lost access to our base defenses. Mm-hmm. Great, yeah. That's great. So we are completely defenseless. We get completely bite off the map already. Okay, we try to reboot that arsenal someplace, if possible. Yep, this is essentially already a mission failure, I can already tell. Yep, so it will be one of those missions where the initial... look at this. Okay, there's no point of doing anything, but we can at least keep observing and see what we are looking at. So, more towards vehicles or van, they seem to come from the north someplace. Going all the way around, maybe exploiting some of these. Alright. Okay, but obviously this, maybe there is a way to path through here after all. Okay, so we have to defend at the earliest convenience, but of course, yeah, this is lost cause. Yeah, just get over with folks and blow us some bits and then we try again. Hopefully have more luck next time. But I was not mistaken by assuming that the opposition as well as the mission will be extremely tough. Mm-hmm. So look at this, we have at least 8 vehicles incoming per wave and a couple more by the way. And I build up more structures as soon as possible, and apparently we're not talking about the Hubum, but actually the Metars, wherever they are, they seem to use the same type of a ship, you know, technology abilities. Okay, so this is their basic vehicle, but it's about 3 to 4 times more powerful than our combat vessels by comparison. Oh, it's great. Yeah, there goes our colony hub. I think. Just have to wait for the animation to finish. Oh, good job, folks. Thank you. Job well done.
Failing this mission is devastating to the Klingon Empire.
Of course it is, but what we are supposed to do, right?
A great victory.
Okay, we try again, but I'm not sure we can pull this off, to be honest, because as you just saw, this is, yeah, I mean, it's just impossible. If they give us triple the amount of ships, it would be a different story, but it's not something we can make happen here, really. Yeah, don't even use the Vicon vessel. We already know all the angry dudes are in the vicinity, yes, and we have not provided with anything, like, whatsoever. We have to build up everything from scratch, and the other mining fields we have over there, they do not anything, yeah, absolutely nothing. Yeah, these folks are useless, they will just get blasted to bits. Maybe you can put a couple of artillery pieces on top of these mountains. Nope, it's impossible, not possible. Oblash, of course. This is too far away to engage the enemy. Yeah, so I see there's nothing we can do, so we just have to, I don't know, maybe put them in the potential blind spot, even though there were swarmers from the right, there were swarmers from the south, so, and if we put them here, they will end up right in the crossfire. Okay then, artillery pieces go back there for now. All the ones we have, which is not a whole lot. The APC is useless, so we can hide with the science vessel. And then we don't any waste any time with scouting right now. And these guys, well, they're also useless. I mean, it's only two tanks. They cannot accomplish anything. Yeah, absolutely nothing, but we can set them to base defense regardless. Okay, just focus all of our attention on base building, because then we don't have to leave this view. Okay, so we need power, and I think that was actually a suitable spot, because then we also blocked the access to this side, assuming it's even possible. So, lots of angles to defend, lots of angles to set down, yeah, these various defenses. And we don't have access to minerals, of course, because we cannot set down anything over there, as it would appear. Eco yard, where we, yeah, of course the artillery is actually important, and actually useful in this instance, at least I'm hoping so. Yeah, sickbay as a fertile item needs to be on. Yeah, maybe put this here and the arsenal can go in the back again. Maybe that's something we can work with. And maybe actually the flying vehicle over there and spotting them actually triggered them. I'm not quite sure. But the pop camp will be a limiting factor as well. Yeah, so I'm really loving getting wiped off the bath in the first 10 minutes of the mission. I think it was even less than that. Okay, well, make yourself useful in some fashion. We need access to these minerals. Maybe I see. I actually have to find out how we can path through there, or if at all.
Power generator complete.
Still completely cooked up, isn't it? Yeah, so we are way too busy building all this stuff. Come on, guys. Get these construction bees to walk. Science vessel extremely slow. So. Okay, we build a Vicon vessel, at least one, to find out what's going on. And there's something here, a clipping, still being persistent, even though it should not be. Okay, there we go.
Vehicle complete.
Our construction beast, we can at least build a couple
vehicle
of those.
Manufacture delayed.
Of course, already? Okay,
vehicle
never.
Complete.
Course, really?
Vehicle complete.
Already built that one Vicon vessel, that seems a little excessive to me. Yeah, we need access to some minerals at the very least. Can we make that happen? That would be great. At least a second mine, if you can manage.
Science station standing by.
Yeah, we need lots and lots of turrets. We need lots of future generators. That also means that we need lots of power. So we need to set down these basic things before we can replace them with the advanced variety. And the arsenal is also essential, of course. Yeah, get this out of my sight here, please, thank you. We have other things to worry about right now. Sick best building build. Construction cannot be upgraded right now. See, why do we have two vehicle yards? So wait, it's a little wasteful, wasn't it? They paid a little more attention then. The station is being upgraded. Okay, did it unlock anything? No, not yet. So apparently this is the only way we... Well, that's not working, is it? Get back home, please. Before we make contact with the enemy forces, because we are well aware of their position right now. And then we try to find something on the other side. So we are completely boxed in from every single direction, but it makes it somewhat defensible if it's the only choke point. Just a matter of getting our defenses up and running at the earliest convenience. Okay, you head over there and then we'll make yourself useful later on. So apparently it takes the construction beast to trigger the charges, which is interesting. On that, yeah, we cannot even put our artillery pieces on top, as you've seen, so I'm not quite sure how we can intercept anything, realistically speaking. And these vehicles are also extremely fast, so this is the, well, I mean, looking at this relief, I don't think that they have two paths available. If you put them here, maybe this would, well...
Construction complete.
I think leaving them in the back is better than expanding them on the front lines. The thing we need, of course, for the all-important vehicle crews. Yeah, shield generator, very important. Also, we also need is a requirement. So now we cannot set it down because there is a ground scout in the way. Okay, get out of here, please. Should move automatically, really. There we go.
Science station standing by.
Also, that second mine would be good if you can do so. Science station. Did I build the wrong type of facility? No, there's the construction yard. Where's our resource collector? So, oh, that was a critical mistake already, wasn't it? I mistook it for a different structure. But hopefully we can fix this still. This is something we need to preserve. This is a wood block of critical access. Well, what is in the way? Probably the television piece, yes. Resource reactor. There we go. Finally. Well, so, we're kind of resourced off already, so with all these resources we cannot process anywhere. Well, that's a little silly of me, you know, overlooking this. So this needs to be upgraded. I think we can now set down the first of many ship generators. Maybe, apparently not, so at least the Colony House has become unlocked. I cannot see anything on the minimap just yet, but we have not done any VCON granted. So let's get in, yeah, let's not get too comfortable. Arsenal is coming online. That means I should give us access to the next shield generator.
Science station standing by. Security systems ready.
Yeah, there we go. So, first shield generator, and I think we put it squarely. So, already people incoming, so maybe I spoke too soon. I bet they're blowing up. This is completely defenseless, and these guys are too far out of position. Great, great, just great, just great. I'm loving this. So we don't even have 5 minutes of grace period here, so we need all these turrets. We cannot build them because the shield generator isn't online yet. Are you kidding me with this? Get your asses over here. God damn it. How in the world are we supposed to do this with the forces at hand? Tell me this, please. get this thing online here already. Yeah, now it will be a relentless wave of reinforcements, one after another. Yeah, so this thing... So this disruptor turret, yeah, build it, build it, build it. All of those. Yeah, I know it is finished, but what are you doing? They're useless. Man, I can't really do anything other than worrying about setting up all defenses, and it will be a relentless wave of reinforcements. Yeah, unsurprisingly, so we need defense on every side. Put up another shield generator. It is convenience. We would. Did we lose the arsenal already? No, something has been destroyed because I cannot put any more turrets at the moment. Hey, can you make yourself useful? Fucking pieces of shit. And they have access to those cloak vessels as well, that's also good, right? Yeah. Yeah, I kind of lost track. Something got destroyed, I think it was the medical bay. Yeah, we're shooting. There we go, okay.
Warning. Colony power insufficient. No. System shutting down.
Yeah, I know. We need to upgrade everything at once, essentially, with the few resources we have available. So that thing here, because it's sluggish as hell, since I forgot to set it down in the beginning of the game, more or less. Visualist yard, so... Okay, can you move a little closer, please? All of the way, the very least. Science vessel is useless, why are you even up front? Hide back here, please. Okay, one of many, we need power. Yeah, we need the medbay back online. It's already way too crowded.
Resource structure complete.
Need our turrets firing at all times, that the shields going to go down ideally. Okay, so finally we have some protection. Miniscule amount. Good defense. Sure, I'll put this right here, but I'm more worried about the disruptors at the moment. If I can find it, it is. Good defense, there we go. Another one on this side, please. Front door. Yeah, I know, I would like to. We got the shield generator here, we are way outpassing our ability to power all this stuff. So advanced power generator, we can build this here, it's good, but it also blocked the path, so...
Construction delayed.
Yeah, okay. Maybe we have to make do with a couple of artillery pieces if we can build them yet, or we build them, I should say. Okay, only one apparently because we are close to the pop cap. We are extremely, we completely made this out, aren't we? Yeah, so we have an ED. No, get this out of here. Where is it? No. The vehicle, please. Thank you. We have to set down that medbay again before we do anything else. Apparently it was too late. Well, then we have to wait for something to be destroyed or waste something. But can we waste for that matter or destroy these ships? Yeah, maybe they can suicide them. It's only that useless APC. Just get over there. Just these fools, and we have the next wave of reinforcements incoming already. Yeah, get over here. Here's static a defense piece. That's so fantastic. Let's see what we're looking at. So, power situation has stabilized a little bit, yes. No, not really. We're running on reserve power for the most part. But only. Yeah. Goddammit. Why are the Tobots working with the new alien faction? For that matter, I don't quite understand, to be honest. Yeah, one objective required still, I think. That would be to locate, and yeah, I'm not quite sure where they are. Are these tanks trying to chase down some fucking idiot again? I think they are, right? Can you please return back under shield coverage? That would be good. Yeah, I can go to the valley point and I give you no orders. But this thing has to suicide itself against the defenses. I don't care. It's completely useless anyhow. But this is the answer we need later on. Yeah, the crew management in this game is not particularly enjoyable sometimes. It's very limiting. I mean, they should give you at least one emergency pop cap at all times so you can at least build the medbay, for instance, you know. I think it would be reasonable, but we cannot have that in this game, of course. Can you blow up that thing? Finally, thank you. Since I really would, wanted to get blown up. Yeah, it really locks the build button. You can't do anything until the situation has been resolved. And we at least look over there and see what's going on. So we have... Sure, well, that seems reasonable in my book, and this is a large blocking force consisting of, if they have a big traffic jam and the AI is screwing up as a result, it's something we can work with perhaps. So there we go, we finally can build that medical wing again. I can find it because it's not a very distinct looking building, it's gray on gray all around. So, once again, we are running, running rather low on thermoconductive material, which will be fun outside. God damn it. So the artillery pieces are safe under coverage, and I think, there are actually... Yeah, there we go. You can make yourself useful on this side under shield coverage, that would be good. Also, don't do anything stupid, just stay there. The defense turret also stood on 9, which is good, but I'm not quite sure why the advisor is in helmet on these photon defense pieces. We need the disruptors, they are more useful, of course. Sufficient power, yeah. We are going beam for us in every single mission. Okay. Two photon turrets. Well, we need that many at least for the base, yeah. And afterwards, we'll probably do our little trick. Alright. So, mine has already been exhausted, which is not good. Science vehicles. Yeah, well, we need eyes on them, apparently, but we cannot move through there because there's only one path to go. And these things, other being hovercraft, they cannot go over the mountains. Yeah, alright. Upgrade that thing, please. Need advanced the power station at least one of those, and yeah, what's the power situation actually like? Probably not very good. Yeah, we have nothing in reserve, or the batteries have been completely drained. Yeah, we need this for the farm, I think. Do we not? I'll put it here then. So we are back to the full pocket that we set down then. Yeah, so we can start building some more destructive pieces, I think, if we can manage. Yeah, I don't think photon turrets on top of here as a defense are very useful, but if that's what the game wants us to do, I think we have to oblige. Yeah, but how did they fucking bypass our defenses again? Get over here! Get over here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Ask these idiots. You have to be kidding me with this. You absolutely have to be kidding me with this. And these things are useless, aren't they? Yeah, so there goes one of many buildings. And blow up these idiots. Blow them up. Thank you. Of course, you don't have a construction yet anymore. That's fantastic. Yeah, oh man. Don't put the artillery pieces right on front here. Thank you. Wow, we had a couple of setbacks here in case you haven't noticed. Yeah, quite a few setbacks. So, once again, that's fantastic. Okay, why don't we put one artillery piece here perhaps? Yeah, once again, also pathfinding is an issue because our base is rather congested. It's something we have to live with at the moment, unfortunately. So two pieces over here, and I'm not quite sure. See, this is impossible with our vehicles, even though it should be plenty in real life, but that's something we have to be content with as well. Okay, two artillery pieces here, then we have two on top, and hopefully there's the next wave incoming. So, guess that thing online, please. I give you an order, build it. What? We don't have materials to build a construction yard? Wow, really? Of course, they blew up the storage facility. Oh, wow, so that's not something we can recover from, I'm pretty certain. Yeah, so, wow, that's an instant game over, essentially, because there's no way to gain any more resources, because apparently if we cannot store them anywhere, even though we have the resource processor online still, we cannot make use of these minerals. Oh, that's great. Absolutely fantastic. Well, so, wow, that's another thing they could have ironed out during the beta phase, if there was one for this particular title. Well, then I can just restart the mission, because there's no way to finish this here, unfortunately. Oh, man, I thought that was one of the problems we actually fix, you know? Fantastic. Yeah, so, this game is just a goddamn buggy mess. Well, we're finally making some progress, folks, but of course, due to all that weapon we're building, we kind of resource stuff already, but I think that's something we can fix in due time. And as it turns out, if you build everything as fast as possible, and you're even completely on the ball like I was, getting the first hold online happens just in time for the first of many reinforcement waves, and now we just have to see what we can make happen. So, yeah, so as you can see, we're already mining out all these fields, unfortunately, and the other angles are impossible. And yeah, so I'm not, I do not think we're supposed to stay like this, like indefinitely. We have to, but first things first, yeah, we have to make sure that our base is something we can leave behind and divert our attention elsewhere. It also calls for more of these rather useful, static defenses.
Building construction.
Yeah,
delay.
So the problem is usually is the, I think it's the chemoproductive material as well as the transparent aluminum, and I'm not quite sure if there's a bottleneck someplace, because at the moment I am not quite sure, so we cycle through our mining outposts to see what's going on. So we have lots of crates on the ground, so probably that's due to a lack of suitable transportation, if I had to guess. Yeah, I know, but I think we're hanging on here, but at least this time.
Vehicle complete.
Get a couple of cargo bees, please. Probably a couple too many because we cannot scrap them later. But yeah, so crisis has been averted for now, and I think the mistake was, trying to restart the mission for the for time instead of restarting the game, because it's not simply because of emulation. The quick lagging feature breaking us is because of the an inherent bug in the engines in place that has not been addressed with the fanmade patch for the panda. Okay, maybe we can replace one of those. That would also be a good idea. Was in the free up the pop cap. Probably we can, yeah, so it's fantastic. Hopefully we can afford to do so.
Vehicle complete.
It also is good for their pathfinding as well, so we can
building construction.
Yeah,
delay.
But of course we cannot. So hopefully the crates will be brought to our resource processor sooner than before. That seems to be the vehicle bottleneck for on every mission essentially. Getting very hectic, as you can see. And that's why we have not built a single defense turret, because I'm relying on a mobile artillery. These are much cheaper to build. And these settings, have to say, at least don't let this guy fly past, you know. At least for the most part. Yeah, the middle seems to be most useful, but there's very cold already. But at least it's more than one target for them. The VPs, yeah, you have one on this side, please. Got the power generator.
Building construction delay.
Oh, I'm getting mighty tired of hearing that, but it's not like we have access to any more mineral fuels. It seems to be impossible. I mean, we could try to see something with our science vessel if I can find it, and it's still intact, thankfully. But there's nothing in the way of survival for them, unfortunately, so it seems to be impossible. Well, we try to go here then.
Vehicle complete.
Oh, lovely, another artillery piece.
Vehicle complete.
And even our two tanks are still alive, would you imagine that?
Vehicle complete.
I don't think they're as effective as a disruptor turret and certainly not as durable. Yeah, because I don't see any crates being moved outside or waiting for processing, so I guess it's just the reoccurring problem with not having access to the correct minerals. Mm-hmm. At least we are close to the top cap. We completely maxed out except for 5, which I don't think, I don't remember how we can get, possibly because we have already buildings available and set down, I believe, including the livestock farm for reducing load on our power grid. Please set it down finally. There we go.
Vehicle complete.
Then we can start raising some of these.
Maybe vehicle complete.
Well, they're actually quite safe over there, but we need vehicle the pop-cap, you know, so what can be done about it?
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, it will be a long time before we can afford to go on the offense here, I'm afraid. Just have to scramble for resources and also try to hang on as much as possible. Oh, so, there we go. Thankfully. And now hide back in the safety, because we need you later and rather not expend resources for building this thing. Oh, lovely. Suction delayed, insufficient, and yeah, so same goes for our vehicles. Yeah, they're very safe, but if they have punched their way through, you know, all the way back here, it's a lost cause already. Regardless of what else we do. Oh, wait, we need another advanced power generator. But if they have pathfinding issues because of the layout of our base, then we can exploit this naturally. And since we now have no further use for this area back there, I think we just park these vehicles someplace else. Yeah. Oh, Blech, of course. And then we build this crew here with the advanced power generator, so it's one of those. About static defenses, we need some turrets we can put on top here just to satisfy the objective, but I don't think we really need to, except for that. Yeah, so I don't think friendly fire is a concern in this case, but since the, I mean, it makes it a little safer, I suppose. But so what about the pop cap? We are completely mixed up. We need more of those to fight our way for the rest of the mission. But maybe we can at least take all of our vehicles, assuming the basic defense is hold. Okay, well, I'm not quite sure. We'll see. Maybe we can scrap something else, make it something destroyed, but I don't think there's anything else we can do in terms of maxing up our pop cap. Put on defense. I don't think this is within shield coverage, but I guess we will have to lift that for now. 2 is the objective requires, I guess. And it's, yeah, if they put it here, they can fire on it probably. Also, some defenses back here would be nice. It's not like we can, yeah, if they're already back there, I don't think they would, yeah, would have already breached our last line of defense, more or less. So let's see about objectives. Complete and complete valor should be, really, I think science vehicle war, of course, scientists and the other, supposed cowards. Even though there's no shame in using escape pods, you know. Especially if your ship has been provided with, sent pods. I don't think it's completely in line with the Klingon, yeah, Klingon warriors way. I see the photon turrets aren't actually useful because they cannot move in targets, more or less. It's a problem. So 80, right. Alright, well, that's good. Maybe we can hold on to this position then. And otherwise, I don't think there's anything we can or should be doing right now. So I think we invest the rest of our money or dough in... well, we need one recon vessel at the very least. Maybe we can do some careful scouting with our science vessel. So there we go. Actually, can shoot on this. Oh, that's not good. Well, then we have to invest in a shield generator. So these things don't get blown to bits all the time. So don't have to babysit them necessarily. There we go. But vessels moving in for an exosuit, and I can obviously, I mean, look at this, it's outrageous, yeah, I know. So it came down to learning the beginning of this mission, but even so, I scrambled for, you know, my first attempt wasn't actually terrible, it was just a matter of getting quickly overwhelmed. Speaking of which, it will, yeah, probably happen here as well. So, well, there's only one access available, and the traffic jam has reoccurred, so that's just an easy. But of course, these are also artillery pieces. Well, artillery is as good as ours, and we don't have a mobile shield generator, unlike the Federation, I believe. So, what are we looking at? Another aesthetic here, well, probably AI is broken on them. So, we can only proceed for here, and we have a pretty large formation waiting for us here as well as there. And then afterwards we can go away exactly, because I think the entire plateau is impassable, and knowing how this game likes to screw with you, I think one of the escape ports will be in this little cubbyhole on the vendor back. And then we have to, yeah, probably go over here as well, so that's, yeah, but then the Tower base will be in the general vicinity, not that we can destroy it with any degree of reliability, and yeah, so it seems to be impassable anyway. Maybe through here, but I doubt it to be honest. So that leaves this area to deal with first. Alright, we queue up as many artillery pieces as we dare to, which is a whopping form. And then we fight our way through these blocking force at the very least. And then I yeah, I think it's something we have to do. So, let's see, I think we need the science vessel. That's a mandatory thing in this particular mission. Okay, the escape port of scientist door. Okay, using this. Alright, so we cannot do this with recon vessel, unfortunately, so that means we have to squat this thing at all times. So everything is in this lovely big formation. Okay, then we set them to squad number one, and then well, we see what we can find. Hopefully, we'll bump into reinforcements right away, and these are completely stationary. Well, hopefully, we can get advantage though to use our own artillery against them, because they cannot fly past here. I mean, this perfect process to go. We cannot. Oh, great, yeah, that's lovely. Make yourself useful there, turrets, thank you. Yeah, we have to wait for a formation to form, so this doesn't happen, you know, big traffic jam. Of course, our, yeah, therefore. please don't blow up too many artillery pieces, yes. Yeah, good thing we're leaving some behind, right? Man, so annoying. Get over here. Something I didn't want to happen, you know. They're bumping into our attack force. Okay. Yeah, make yourself useful, please. But as long as our defenses last, is something we can live with. Okay, tons and tons of angry dudes just waiting over there, but they won't remain inactive. I can already guarantee. The Mandarin field we should exploit, where we have ice on that. Okay, maybe this would work. God damn it. Okay, we need access to these minerals. Maybe we can set down a mine here, while we have the opportunity. Look at this. I mean, this is just relentless wave after wave after wave. And of course, there is not a suitable, a single suitable tile here. So, wow. It's just a waste of time then. I think we already lost a couple of the vehicles, unfortunately. Okay, everyone, we have work to do. May not be stupid, please. I'm so worried about our leaving our base unattended, but this is only one way to get there. Maybe this will be safe-ish. Well, if they stay, well, I don't think they will remain inactive once we the first, yeah, will probably wake up already. Maybe not. Oh, then we can blast them to bits. It's a shooting gallery. Unfortunately, we don't have cool experience in this game. There we go. That's what I thought. Okay, keep moving then. Keep moving. Keep moving. And be a big sitting target, yes. Wow. Frame rate is really tanking for all the lighting effects. And now we cannot knock these trees over because these are hover tanks and not attract vehicles. Oh, imagine if they could use this formation against our base, that would be devastating. Yeah, oh, and unfortunately, they also focus fire on the same vehicle at the same time. At least I don't have to direct this manually. That would be horrible. Manual targeting. At least they're stationary and we are not. And we can outrange them by a couple of meters apparently, well, if we aren't stupid it is, like this guy. So worried about the artillery pieces though. Oh, great! Yeah, of course our artillery pieces are completely defenseless, point blank, more or less. And they have to come unstuck every day, or maybe it's just another force, I'm not quite sure. But these have to go no matter what else we do. Well, just replenishing them. Yeah, I mean, it would be suicide for all science vessels, we know that much already, it cannot go past here. A couple more artillery pieces. Yeah, we lost so many already, so can expand them later on. Oh, I mean, look at this. We didn't even take down half the forces they have over there. Take a look at this. Yeah. Okay, we just fell past it. Try to ignore them for now because they're not attacking us. And all of our ships will get wiped out anyway. That much I can already tell you. So try to find something of interest before the reinforcements get here and they cut us off. Oh, come on. Yeah, per fighting in this game. Maybe this will be outside of effective weapon range at least. Yeah, keep moving, guys. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh god, it was too late anyhow. We're already up against the next formation. And we have one lovely formation of vehicles trying to be stupid again. And this is even the top faction. Yeah, we have to go over there. There's absolutely no alternative for maybe... Oh man, this is a disaster already. Keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. So we're ending up in a crossfire situation regardless of how well I try to set up things. Oh. Okay, maybe we try to go the other way and try deal with the Taubert because they are of the two factions, they are the easier one to deal with. Relatively speaking. Yeah, maybe I don't think the game will be the generous, but the only thing I can come up with right now. Yeah, we get completely decimated, completely decimated. Okay, guys, go back to the ready point. Whoever will be surviving this here. Jesus fucking Christ, Jesus fucking Christ. Really? How did they fucking get over there already? Alright, can we set down a couple more of these disruptor things? Thank you. Yeah, so much for leaving our base defended, right? Yeah, everyone has been destroyed already. Yeah, pretty much. This is a dead end. Yeah, these things have to go. This is the only opportunity I can see. Maybe, we'll try it? Question mark? We have some artillery. There's already next couple of idiots incoming. Oh, man. We probably have blasted 100 vehicles already, all rounders combined. Yeah, one vehicle at a time getting one of these turrets, and there's a... Man. Here, keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. Destroy these things. Only a couple left, at least as far as we can see. Wow, of course they have more friends waiting for us. I don't really care, we try to grasp here at the top of this mountain before it's completely inaccessible. Of course the science vessel is trying to... Over here. Look at this. They're stuck behind the enemy. Try in the path around. He lost so many things already. So, is this everyone? No, we already get quicker. Okay, can we pass over here? I think we can though, right? Oh, find some belief. No, hoplash. Hoplash. Nope, it's not possible. Great. It's great. Get this fucking formation over here, that can't be so hard. is away from the enemy fire. It is from the relentless wave of reinforcements, and then we can maybe use these artillery pieces back here to fire at the enemy. What are you doing? Get your asses over here, you fucking useless drivers. Yeah, that's good news. Oh man, this game sometimes, I tell you. Okay, well, there's nothing we can do. I think the science vessel is actually still here with us. That's interesting. Yeah, we can. I mean, this is the only path. This is absolutely the only path we can take. And I take the strongest formation we can afford in terms of the pop kit right now. And even so, it's completely undoable, I'm afraid. So we just have to hope that our science vessel will survive the encounter, which does not appear to be particularly likely to be. Maybe I'm missing the obvious, but we cannot really set down all these turrets. I mean, we are already completely maxed out. Maybe if I double the pop cap available, that would be a different story. Yeah, there will be more friends waiting for us. So there's nowhere we can go. We're literally speaking right. So we try to hide in this little cubby hole. If our friends can find a proper path. And then we try to set down a turret, I guess. Since we have... we can scrap it later if it's... Yeah, see, that's what I mean. Ugh, you have to be kidding me with this. I mean, look at this. We'll exploit this then, I suppose. Well. Nothing else to say, really. We are completely maxed out already. Wow, that's fantastic. Oh, it's looking great. Wow, wow. We have to go through here as a reminder. This is not optional. Well, I don't know what to tell you, folks. I don't know what to tell you. The enemy can still puff around here, which means now, I guess we... Where are you going? Put yourself over here, you fucking idiots. Yeah, and then we try to exploit this again, because we have a couple of free spots here, more or less. Otherwise, I don't think that will be particularly durable. This is well within the artillery range, unsurprisingly. Maybe we should have started with the shield generator. I think it's actually just one wave after another, being on top of each other, more or less, right? Ugh, yeah, there we go. Jesus Christ. Get that shield generator online if you would, thank you. That's of course also very far away from our base. I'm willing to stand up against concentrated fire such as this, no. Maybe some static disruptors, but we need at least a phalanx of those. But if we put them all forward, then we can scrap most of them back at the base. More or less. Yeah, something we can consider at the very least, but I don't want to rely on these fucking static defense all the time just to game the system. Yeah, so down to 3, and the science vessel has been destroyed, so there's no way to proceed with this feat. Yeah, I mean, just head back home, thank you. Yeah, just try to survive here. And then we have to exploit this in some fashion. Once again, overlapping shield generators does not accomplish much for us, I believe. Hopefully they can fire on targets passing by, then we have at least this angle on lockdown. Well, it's kind of silly, but also kind of fun, you know, gaming the well, game in that regard, if that's what you have been provided with. Yeah, okay, of course. Oh, Okay, but looking at, we have exactly two pieces remaining. I don't think I can rebuild them as fast as they destroy them. Yeah, of course, body power is insufficient. Set up one of those, please. So, everything good in the base, yes, but we cannot pull back or script anything on second floor because, well, obviously the next couple of idiots incoming, don't we? Yeah, more Torbot. So, this seems to be yeah, the point where they have to converge. So, more or less. This is definitely traffic jam incoming. They cannot actually fire, is it correct from this angle? Yeah, that's what I thought. Also keeps them target locked apparently. Maybe it was just them powering down because they had insufficient electricity available. What makes sense?
Building construction delay.
Yeah. Actually, I can fire past the targets. Maybe just. Maybe not. Not quite sure. I don't think the angle is working for them, but then we just waste the entire batch. Just those two. Something else with the resources. Okay, so we have dealt a killing blow to them, at least for the time being, but also yeah, made the entire formation become unstuck, right? Oh, wait, that's not very good. So they can still pass through here without abandon, apparently, so maybe can sit down. We can do anything at the same time, of course. So also useless, should waste them. Yeah, these are too fast for our turrets, unfortunately. But wow, that worked out in the end somehow. But it also means we cannot destroy anything with our base. So once again, I'm asking the question how we are supposed to do this. Okay, let's see. Nothing we can upgrade, nothing we can do really at our base still, so... I mean, just... Yeah, there's just no break or anything we could do. Really, I'm not even sure where the vehicle yards are because our formations get wiped out so quickly at all times, you know. And we lost the entire strike force for the third time. So we have the science, but so still, actually we don't. It has not survived the encounter. Yeah, so maybe, I don't know, I really don't. Maybe we can just try to scoot past here with that thing. Directing it manually in total doesn't get blown to bits immediately, or maybe a formation of 5, because our combat vessels are quite useless, evidently. Completely and utterly useless, as a matter of fact. So there's not even any point of trying to go out there with another formation of photon artillery pieces. Oh, so. At least they can give us ice some. Yeah, so. Or maybe we can set on the mine someplace as well. Alright, folks, so we have these rather lovely tanks here. I can obviously see what is on the minimap, and yeah, it's not even all the forces we can see. And the formation of photon artillery, as well as these things, they won't accomplish anything. So we just race inside this little canyon and try to kill everyone as soon as possible without them wiping us out in return, which will be in turn order, of course. It's yeah, pathfinding and so on and so forth. So can you please concentrate fire on those? Thank you. Oh. Only two ships, yes, and we lost half of information from that alone. Okay, has the path been cleared? I think it has been, so we can hopefully swing in with our science vessels. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Okay, I hope they don't get intercepted again. Because they are very slow and also very vulnerable, even though they are a little better shielded than the other ones. And the recon vessel in particular, which is, would not be suitable for this job, unfortunately. Okay, well, so hopefully that's something we can tackle at the very least, but that will be only one of multiple objectives because yeah, we have to recover four escape pods minimum, I believe, in this mission, which I remember for the briefing. And if we inject this, then we can see, yeah, so this something. That's probably not the scientist, that would be way too easy since it was not as heavily defended as the other route, which we probably have to take. And there's also some. What are you doing? Can you. Ah, so there we go. So, yeah, I think we built at least 10 science vessels throughout the mission. Only one survived, or any two have survived, yeah. Okay, we just take this one, and hopefully this will be good enough. Because the, yeah, maybe we should be able to scan this. if you can get over there for that matter. Oh, don't tell me that's bugged out. Really? Oh, we tried from both sides, that's why we have 2 versus 2 us. Right. So it's automatic, which is good. We do not know who it is, yes. Or at least they're not telling us.
Objective completed.
So, alright, so this seems to be the most important one for the better. And then we have to keep a look out for the other ones, which I'm not quite sure where they are. But since we have a couple of hover cars together with these recon vessels, I mean, not really recon, but maybe we can see if we cannot exploit this overhead passage in some way, because there was one, over here. But hopefully the structures can hold for now. It seems to be not being updated in real time, but we left a couple of pieces behind, and we also scrapped some disruptors just in case we need them later in some other position. And I think, yeah, these are some overhead bridges. Now it's just a matter of how we get over there, and so of course more friends incoming. Actually, maybe we use one disposable recon vessels to just find out. Yeah, it seems to be a better idea because it takes like 10 minutes of your time, 15 minutes minimum to find an opening for vessels to get through, and building these one after another is very slow affair as well. Okay, get at least a little closer, maybe find some window fields on this side, but it seems to be unlikely. These recon vessels are relatively quick to pop out. It's already waiting for us, that's excellent. So let's see, we just put it over here and see where it wants to go, but probably it was unfortunate route, most likely. There's some opposition, bare minimum. But at least we have stopped the initial onslaught of relentless reinforcement waves getting to our base, which is good, except for these powerful beings. Yeah, this one for instance. Okay, we just have to hide here until they're going blasted immediately, because wow, it's a one-hit kill for them. And we have to shoot generator and some turrets to keep them busy. But if we are caught in the open, yeah. Just hide back there, thank you. Yeah, this is their main combat tank. So, why is this averted? Now how do we get over there? Looked a little funny. So it's right back here. Oh, that is relatively easy then, isn't it? Okay, and we can use this opportunity then. So they're already coming back. Well, that's why we have the turrets still in position. At least half of those. Well, we tried. Are you kidding me with this? Fired, and we have a couple of phaser tanks to welcome that one idiot patrolling over there. We certainly get that far, but yeah, there we go. Another one to blast it. It's a side I'm very much in approval of. Come on. Oh, wait, what else can we see? Well, we can vessel for that matter since we are just waiting. No more people just waiting for us. It's always fantastic. And yeah, I think I was not mistaken in my assumption that we have to go over there in some fashion. Well, yeah, I don't think we can actually see it with our eyes. It's something we have to uncover with our science vessels, most likely. And it's probably over here together with another blocking force, which means we should probably build. Oh, interesting. So maybe that's actually their base. Well, it's very extensive, extremely so. So hopefully we don't have to. Well, that would explain why they have these resources to at their disposal pump out these ships one after another. Yeah, that's quite. Well, hopefully we won't be quite to wipe this out, because I don't see how in a million years. Can we at least get out of their fire before they come back? It would be slow. There's only one ship. Can you engage it, please? Yeah, too late already. Yeah, fantastic. Okay, then we just scoot. See what we can find or did not find. Hopefully one science vessel will have survived from this. We're already down a couple of ships, so what do we want to build? For whatever reason, I don't have access to the better disruptor tank. It's not displaying unavailable in my menu, unfortunately, but these. Wait, just build as many as we can, and they will be destroyed anyway. Giving order, could you please catch up? Thank you. So, probably blocking force in every single passageway we could take. No eyes on anything in particular, and maybe we could expand one photon turret just to blast them to bits. Yeah, just grab one of these tanks here. Thank you. Set up one turret. There should be... Well, there should be with invasion. If it gets blasted, it does not concern me that much. Yeah, over here some place perhaps it would do. So, what else are we doing yet? Of course, another artillery piece. It's something we could rush from for the... Maybe it's not as heavily defended as I thought it would be, but they can also shoot out on top of here, of course. So get these tanks moving. It's the first instance of the sky bridge we have seen in the game, I believe. Yeah, there we go. Just keep moving. Avoid the artillery. On the plateau back here someplace, it could be probable, but I won't be the counter, to be honest. Yeah, get moving, guys. Stop your sitting duck.
Vehicle complete.
Of course, this is a one-tile affair. Okay. We need a little time to catch up, at least the science vessels are falling behind, which in this instance is actually preferable. Lots of mineral fields we cannot exploit, unfortunately. Yeah, and they're doing without artillery versus artillery. Yeah, there we go. So at least their artillery is also a little squishy, yeah.
Vehicle complete.
Oh, look at this down there. Yeah, really quite unfortunate, isn't it? Cannot see anything right now because our science vessels are too far behind, but at least they're still intact. It is more than we could say for them previously. So this is the way down, somehow. Maybe, I'm not quite sure, but this is actually give us access to, except for, yeah, foundations for our artillery pieces if we want to use them. But there's no way we can take out that base, relatively speaking. We have to avoid the enemy if possible, so this is a potential way down.
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, I would like to pull him forward right away, but if they're not in formation, it would be sitting ducks anyway. So two more escape pods, some place, I think. Once again, I think we should actually, we need eyes on them with someone, preferably our science vessels, otherwise we do not know about the location of these escape pods, because we did not get a proper fix on them, apparently. So what about the other side? We are close to the other map edge.
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, this Ledo Canyon, that seems to be a complete death zone. Very large but also very barren map, especially in terms of resources, but okay, since we have ice on that thing right now, but we can force, yeah, it completely queued up our, completely blocked off actually with vessels. Wow, that's unfortunate. Just move over there so we can move out at the earliest convenience. Yeah, where's that escape pod? Or that second one? Or the third one? I kind of lost the track, to be honest. And this is a dead end, as expected, but how do we get over there then? Or at this little corner for that matter, because it seemed to be offering the highest chance of discovering anything of value. Let's see where they want to go. Yeah, of course, over the bridge. And then, of course, yeah, they want to path through the base one day. Mm-hmm, that's what I thought. So, well, this is obviously not the brightest idea I've ever seen, especially from our vehicle course. So. I mean, it doesn't make... Okay, just hold here for now and I will do some scouting manually and then see what we can find. I mean, we can establish where the base is located. But as for the escape ports, maybe it's all the way in the back here, but that would be quite big fuck you from the game designers, I have to say, because well, this is completely impenetrable, I do believe. We move a little forward and then, yeah, so, okay, then we have to fall back to the old and stupid trick of setting up our static defenses on the enemy side. Oh, I should get them blasted to bits, aren't you? Maybe just, yeah, so this is the structure. Active portal should cover basic, I guess, if we can get ourselves in range and no opposition over here, then can just blast it at infinitum, more or less, right? Okay, so these turrets, they can shoot at our artillery pieces if it came to that, but since only one here in every couple of vehicle yards, so at least stop the Valentis reinforcements here. Okay, we give it a spin. Shoot Grenader first. I think we have tons of construction beasts for that matter. That's why I built them so quickly in advance at the start of the mission. It seems to be a raw file as climate jet already is. We saved up quite a few resources for this eventuality, so free tourists for now, and we also need to settle on a base someplace and hope that the minerals will actually make it to our resource processor. And I think, I'm not sure if this is actually destructible, or you know, if destroying this thing will give us anything. Alright, well, we wait on the results, and then we also have a mineral field here someplace we should exploit if we can. Excellent. Yeah, see how long it takes for us to destroy this thing, even with all the guys fighting at once. And we have to be careful, the enemy patrols also come back here, or just the reinforcement waves. Yeah, photon defense, quotation mark. Sind alle meine Figuren für die assistierte Portal someplace. Maybe on top since we eliminated all the guys around there. Anything else we can scrap via brief? A bit too many cargo beats unfortunately, so consumption 75, so we have plenty in reserve. I think there's anything we can scrap really. Yeah, maybe this cheap generator is not particularly useful in this position. Well, minerals actually scrap some of these mines for that matter, that may also be more fire. Well, we blast into something that will have some good effect. So again, space seems to be at the premium in this area. There we go, thankfully. Hopefully they also leave this alone. It certainly has woken it up, hasn't it? But we have ship coverage and there's only one path for them to get up here, so maybe we support this with a phaser turret. At least one, because they can achieve one-hit kills on the enemy sometimes. Yeah, but it's, I mean, it's stupid that you have to do it like this. That doesn't make any sense in my book, but alright. He set up the horns, didn't it? Yes, this was still relatively productive, and the same goes for this one, so we just leave it for now. Okay, yeah, very angry. And the structure is still intact. Apparently, it's just a vehicle we cannot hit for whatever reason. I don't think destroying the portal will actually stop the reinforcements, but I think they're coming from someplace else. There we go. Blast the thing to bits, please. It's excellent. Resource is flowing again. Any progress? Apparently not, but this keeps them busy. Yeah, see how quickly they can build these. I think they are way outpacing us. They're actually coming up here because it should be impossible for them, at least theoretically. Yeah, apparently that's not something we have to worry about right now. So, are we looking at defenses on their side? I don't think we actually have the. Also, they're blocking this, so that must be all the way back there. That seems to be quite proper to me. So did anyone survive the trip? Actually, they did, right? What's going on? Ah, you big, big dumbos. Get over here, make yourself useful. Thank you. And yeah, there's a problem with artillery pieces. They can outrange all turrets, unfortunately. It seems to be advancing for them anyway, so make yourself useful. Thank you. There we go. Enjoy that. Enjoy that, friends. I'm finally getting to work on these facilities, I see. Actually, can direct it manually? That's interesting. Maybe the button click didn't validate our last mission. But then we obviously focus fire on the turret first. We can get to work on the vehicle yard of theirs. One of many, no doubt. I don't think they're actually obeying the orders, are they? Oh man, this So, well, these keeps them busy, something else to do, and then we can screw the bound and see if we cannot find an opening for our science vessels. Finally, because it took it long enough to get here, maybe these tanks can at least blow up one of these blocking forces. What? Oh, you have to be kidding me with this. Well, that's what I was worried about, of course. Yeah, at least we can blow up a couple of top-board vessels. Much we can handle. Bare minimum. Okay, I guess we just try to go on route without blasting anything. And then only see one structure of a dubious value over here. Yeah, okay. Okay, maybe that's something we can manage, squeeze past, but they probably have a couple of turrets, which means, yeah, that the bomb will be surviving our attack. Or, also be an attack, to be honest. Okay, maybe we can keep them busy with a turret. This is something, that seems to be the recurring theme for us. And this game plays really strange, maybe it's just down to the game balance, whatever. I'm quite sure. Wait for that turret, then the thing will get targeted, or hopefully. Yeah, so something is working as intended, even though it completely breaks the game AI more or less, right? Afraid by the stick. I know, that's top part of the plan. Well, just waiting for the confirmation. There we go, now we can move. We should get target locked immediately. Yeah, exactly as intended. Of course, more people incoming. Yeah. Form this little stupid Congo line, why wouldn't you? Of course, now the turret switches. Yeah, that's great. Well, then, okay, science vessel is gone. Oh, so much for that, I guess. Well, we can at least do some scouting still with these hover tanks. Yeah, but the escape route must be over here someplace. Yeah, another one waiting for us. Yeah, so there we go. It's down to three hover tanks. Make that two. So there's another active portal of theirs, acting as an infinite reinforcement spawn, more or less, right? So that's our formation going. That means that we have to be. You have to be kidding me if this. Our vehicles are so useless, I'm not quite sure what to say about that. As far as we haven't even destroyed anything because there's a focus on the vehicles apparently as opposed to anything else, since they just keep pumping them out after ship, after ship, after ship.
Warning! Colony is under attack!
Well, it was certainly one of the stranger missions I've played thus far, especially in an RTS game, but I think we're finally narrowed down as to where that remaining escape route could be, and it's only over here, behind another blocking force, and we're also pretty stuck for resources, so we grabbed this large mineral field of artilithium, and yeah, the turrets, as usual, they made pretty massive displays, and at least it stopped the relentless force of Tauber reinforcements, and we also took down a couple of these active portals, which is why, wow, things have calmed down, finally. But yeah, I do not appreciate this rather strange approach to RTS gameplay, even though it is quite funny. Yeah, I don't want for this to become a permanent fixture. But okay, the science was of course didn't make it, so we had to rebuild a couple of doors together with these radar tanks, but all the opposition has been eliminated, except for the couple of dudes waiting for us. Hopefully that's something we can do in short order once they arrive. Yeah, the foot artillery also just in case since they're no longer needed back at the base, but I think the first portion of the mission was very fun, very hectic, but also very challenging, and that really bogged down later on after we discovered that the other escape points of course to the other side of the enemy base, yeah, as we expected. And well, I can hope that the game will remain stable for the remaining 10 minutes of this mission or so, because well, I don't want it to crash due to the lack of a safe game function naturally. Yeah, that would be unfortunate. So can we get please? Actually, we don't have to wait for these other people. We just can proceed right away since we have all the forces at disposal. At least I hope so. Okay, then we have the recon. Just go over here, you are useless, and the science scout will just hang back here in safety because this is the only vehicle that can complete this objective, of course. But naturally, should be able to fire over the mountain because I'm not quite sure where the blocking force is actually. Maybe you can move them behind the other formation if I can manage. Don't want to lose too many ships, ideally. At this point, it probably doesn't matter anymore, but as you can see, pathfinding is a massive concern in this game, as per usual. Even forming a traffic jam against the enemies heading the other direction, which is not something I've seen in any other RTS game, if I'm completely honest. So that's the last of our phaser tanks, or disruptor tanks, so they are functional identical. I don't think there's any difference when it comes to shielding, so this will be squad number one. This will be squad number two. And our V-Corns will be squad number 3, and hopefully this will be good enough to ensure success in this instance. So we go forward with our brave warriors and try to blast them to bits by squeezing our way through here. I'm not quite sure where they were, probably back over here someplace, so we just find them. Our full artillery will do its best to eliminate them from afar, which won't go very well, I suspect. And the V-Corn guys, they can just stay back up there, yeah, until we've cleared the path. There they are, see? It's a very narrow canyon, designed in such a way that you can only squeeze through one vehicle at a time, so we will take catastrophic losses, no doubt. Let's look it back here, please. Fire on route, ideally, and not wait in the middle of the canyon. Put artillery, also get a little closer, but we can. Maybe here, this will do the trick, or actually, they're already firing. Can hit that, really? Yeah, that's not a fort. Course not. Oh, come on, guys, get out of this kill zone, please. Oh, right, I think there should be the escape point over here someplace with probably more opposition, so we should just wait for the time being. Wait for artillery pieces to come back. Science vessels. So that we have any scanners at the moment, but this seems to be the last place, so that escape point could be, yeah, so I don't see any other opportunity really. I think this has become extremely sluggish. I think we direct this from the tricorder view just to be on the safe side. Just to make sure that the game doesn't crash. Alright, forward we go, brave warriors. With our remaining, I think it's 6 tanks in total, out of 10 or so. Yeah, it took a long time to build them and then also get them to the other side of the map. Granted, we could have used the concrete slabs probably in the enemy base, but it seems to be a little too brazen even for me. So get over there, please. Tell me, please move forward. That's a very narrow canyon, probably. So, if we arrived at the destination, then that would be great. There it is, finally, so get over here. Exactly where I thought it would be, but this is also indicated on the minimap as something. Yeah, so hopefully this will be good enough then to satisfy all the objectives, and I think this entire mission was under the observation of the Klingon High Council as well. Hopefully they got quite a show in the last mission as well. That certainly was quite the shooting gallery. Alright, then please get over here, folks. Slowpokes, that is. Yeah, you cannot speed them up, unfortunately, and the science vessel is extremely slow. You just, yeah, there we go, Vicon is already arrived, I don't think it will be good enough, right? Mm-hmm, so they fought. Why did you not move forward? Oh, let me guess, there's a big, big traffic jam in that little canyon over there, isn't there? Yeah, must be true. Ah, man, pathfinding in this game sometimes, so we just have to get close enough and then the trigger will be automatic. Ah, man. Okay, maybe I missed something obvious in this mission, but I'm not quite sure how else I was supposed to do this. You saw there was only one choke point, which granted worked to our advantage, but yeah, so the traffic jam could have not have been processed in any other fashion except for long-range artillery. It's actually possible to tweak vehicle values in this game with the 1.1 fan patch. I may actually do this. So I don't think that's quite feasible in the long term. Balancing is completely off. no life signs. No data core, so unfortunately we did not extract all the survivors. At least the data. That's something. This was also what we came here for. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. And then we're out of here, I hope. And indeed we are. So another successful mission for the Klingon Empire. And we have dealt sort of a killing blow to the alien operation on this planet as well.
The Klingon Empire recognizes your prowess. Your victory gives your family great honor.
Yeah, I sure hope so. Yeah, by the way, in case you're wondering, this session lasted for 2 hours and 40 minutes, and I'm not joking here. Of course, I'm not leaving all of this in the video. But yeah, that was quite a bit of downtime, rebuilding our strike forces from scratch, I think, 5 times over, and trying to find another escape point for our Vecon vessels, who did get blown up on multiple occasions, because well, they are not very sturdy to begin with, and the aliens there have very good weapons, and they only need one shot, you know, even when they're only passing by. But finally, we have managed, and then we can hopefully locate the source of this proto device and then put a stop to it, because well, obviously if we let them move out of the Tabula Rasa cluster, that could spell doom for the rest of the galaxy considering how powerful they are. But yeah, I think I have earned a time to relax and also yeah, just take a breather and look over this mission again to see what's going on. But yeah, I think that's all I need for now for New Worlds. As usual, I think for watching and I hope to see you next time.